Good morning, good morning. Get straight on today. It's early, it's 5:30. The cats are scratching at the door. They want me to feed them. It's too early to feed them. They've purposely woken me up. There's still biscuits, which I'm supposed to eat. But as you can see. So, ignoring the cats. Working on the high street on one sketchbook used to be back. It feels weird to say that there used to be so many banks here in the town, and there is now just one bank in the town. But that's happening up and down the country. But a lot of banks just go, well, if you've got cash to pay into your account, you can do it from a post office. It's inevitably if I end up with cash in my hands. If you end up with cash from doing jobs, it gets put on. Most money I receive as a business though is through bank transfer, so. You wait for when you wait for larger organizations, yeah. Should do quite a bit. Although, like, I don't have a haircut, they only accept. Do my open studios. I sent out a card reader by Settle, which I could just use my phone for the same thing as well. So you'll need the card reader if someone's buying over £50. They're spending under £50. It's just tap on the rear of the phone. It all saves up hassle. The only problem is you've got to make sure you've got a decent robot. If it's a repeat customer, I'll tell them to trust them to. Pay by PayPal if necessary. To the pop-up shop. Everything had to be cash, and then someone else would account for it. Today. Got a picture that today is going to be dispatched to Arizona. Sat here on my desk waiting. It is saying that. Postage has gone up since I set up the postage on the website. On my website, so. a little bit of the IMV does send up postage. It's about the equivalent of what it would be to post in the UK. My JosephTravis.com has free shipping in the UK. And the postage works out slightly subsidised by the IMV outside the UK too, so you get the equivalent. Same free postage that inside the UK gets. Just can't afford to post it worldwide for free. As posting it tracked to the States costs £1.75. Not £1.75, £7.75. I think the postage on my website works out at £6, and it's free shipping inside the UK, which would be about £1.75 to send it track, I think. Can't show the parcel itself because it is literally my address, their address, and the price and barcode. Because they get two barcodes on. And on the right is the customs form. As far as possible in those sorts of terms. Just barely scratching on the perspective lines. I get to the point in the next few days where I'll probably get bored again, just drawing. Have to spend a bit more time looking for somewhere to draw. Which could be frustrating. I've spent 19 minutes already just on the drawing. Sorry, please excuse my hiccups. It's the same as always. Cover as much of the surface as we can, as quickly as we can, with the colours that we need. We missed the signage layer. Oh, just have to leave it there. So that layer there, there's the actual one. Should always try and make sure you've mixed up enough paint. I have not. I have to make the mistake of mixing again, which, as you can see, is slightly different colour. was watching a painter yesterday. And just watching them lay down flat washes. Just impressive. Especially as they didn't look flat when you put them on. They looked. They looked like they were changing. I cleaned my desk. It meant that I got rid of all the things I used to clean my brush. Just drop them in. Just got some old notes. Put tape down two sides and made it into a bin. Call Mulligan on the mess and just go, oh, I need that. A little bit of paper that had my work notes on several months ago. Bit everything so I can It's like I used to do my, when I first started doing daily drawing and painting, I would do the drawing in my sketchbook. I do a page full of drawings, so it wouldn't be like a big scene like this. It'd be more like, a couple of books or a couple of bits of fruit. I would then have a big straight piece of paper, stretch with masking tape, and I would use that. And then I would divide the piece of paper into four. Do a quarter a day. So a single piece of paper would last me 4 days. And it would always be like a cheaper watercolour paper. Do acrylic as well, which would be on just like a small I've got wood, which worked well as I could produce those at my day job as a technician. get my old scrapbooks of wood. I've got them in tow. Do one of those today. Two. It's no wonder I was tired all the time. Best eating that. And being full time dad. Which makes it green for? I mean, there's a tree here, but. Oh, for the dog. I was just tired all the time. Because I was being full time dad doing that job. And. Training myself to be an artist. Just constantly washed out. Would not recommend it. Difficult to start him. So although now I'm just working for myself, I've always been. It feels crazy because I just could not find the level of energy anymore. I just don't have it in me at the moment. But I did it for several years. Yeah, I would now set more manageable goals like I do now, where my day sketchbook is literally just one image a day. I'm not trying to kill myself anymore. Do try and draw more than just one a day, but doesn't always happen. And I'm definitely not drawing, doing three separate things I could do with doing shadows. Yeah, this is a long one today. Just taking me longer to Yeah, I need to do some more working towards finished work rather than just sketchbook work, but there's already a ton of it over there. Sort of thing. So, yeah, it can be discouraging sometimes when there's so much. And you don't need to keep going, you need to keep producing more. But those are goals for when the kids are, when the kids are at school, which they're off today. So, hopefully next week we'll get back into the swing of things and we'll get some more finished making stuff. But for today, coming up for 35 minutes. I'm going to call this a day. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.